across the stage and get an official picture taken without their mask on. And that's kind of how it will all go.
All right, and every student graduating today will get named here as part of our broadcast on KBHV. I got to thank all the wonderful folks who have helped make this broadcast possible. Sturgis Photo and Gifts is presenting today's graduation for you. And then we are sponsored today by Sturgis Motorsports, Sturgis Chiropractic, and Ace Hardware in Sturgis. You know, Terry, as part of our salute to all the graduates in the area this year, we have set up a Senior Moments program. Francie Gonji is catching up with the kids who are graduating. She has caught up with some of our great Sturgis graduates. That's coming up next. We're going to hear from Francie Gonji. She has got a couple of social distancing, of course. She has caught up with a couple of the Sturgis seniors, and that is coming up next after this from Sturgis Photo and Gifts. A10, yep. Yep. No, we don't. We will. It's coming this fall. We'll have a translator, yep. moment, but first I want to remind you again about the great sponsors who are helping to make this possible. They include Sturgis Photo and Gifts, who is our presenting sponsor today. Sturgis Motorsports, Sturgis Chiropractic, and Ace Hardware in Sturgis. And boy, so many people have come together. They have these wonderful masks that they're handing out to all the students, and all the staff here will be wearing them. Terry and I have one, and we would be wearing one if we wouldn't be able to talk on the radio. So we're social distancing way back here on the side of the stage, and we've got tarps surrounding us here. That's mainly to keep the wind out.
They're also
the wind
kind of
is really wreaking havoc with their mics.
We felt like we were being quarantined a little bit back here with this tarps up. Yeah. But no, it's basically this wind is a little rough today, but I'd rather have this than the weather we had yesterday.
Oh boy, no doubt. And of course, the KBHB live stream. We want to get the word out there. Go to KBHB's Facebook and we'll be live streaming. Thanks to Jacob West, our good friends here. They are making sure everything is running smoothly. And of course, Bob Davis from Sturgis Photo and Gifts has his drone up right at the moment, sending some great pictures and video from the air today. So we have got all angles covered here today. We've got radio, we've got audio, we got video, we got visual up in the air.
We do. Yeah, the powerhouse dance DJs and sound production and Jacob West. This whole crew is incredible.
Oh, man.
These guys are uber talented. I mean, just getting everything set up and making sure everything is working well. Got to thank them for getting us hooked into the live stream, and hope to make this a pretty memorable occasion today.
And of course, we'll be bringing you today's graduation ceremony commercial free. We will not break for commercials for the entire celebration here today, and that will begin at 1:55 with pomp and circumstance. And we are closing in on that in just 6 minutes. So Francie Gonji is going to catch up with some more Sturgis seniors coming up after a word from our sponsors who are helping to make this broadcast possible today on KBHB Radio.
We will be starting in about 3 minutes. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. We will be starting in about 2 minutes. Welcome to the 2020 graduation ceremony. Graduates, at this time, would you please exit your vehicle and stand outside as we play Pomp and Circumstance? Thank you. At this time, I would like the class of 2020 to continue to stand, and the rest of you may exit your vehicle or you can stay inside as we play our national anthem. At this time, we would ask you to please return to your vehicles as we start the 2020 commencement. In place of applause today, we encourage you to honk your horns when it is time to applause. Parents and students, you should have received an email from me earlier today, and there is a PDF of today's program for you to look at. When your graduate crosses the stage, they will pick up a packet at the end, and there will be multiple programs inside. Good afternoon, Scoopers, and welcome to today's very special graduation ceremony for the Sturgis Brown High School Class of 2020. I want to welcome those listening on the airways on KBHB Radio, 810 AM, and those who are watching the ceremony on our live stream. I want to thank Powerhouse Dance DJs and Jacob West for making today's live stream possible, and for KBHB Radio with Gary Mackey and Terry Anderson for broadcasting the ceremony. I would also like to thank all the staff members that have come today to help out with the ceremony. Whether you are helping with the parents' park or will be helping students a little later, we couldn't have done this without your help. Can you give them a round of applause? I am Pete Wilson, Sturgis Brown High School principal, and I am happy to welcome you to the Sturgis Brown High School, and a special welcome to the class of 2020. Back to your school for this unique ceremony. We are fortunate to be able to honor our graduates today in a modified graduation ceremony with a drive-in feel. However, we do need your cooperation and ask that you stay in your vehicles throughout the ceremony unless you are a part of the ceremony or have to use the restroom facilities. I know the urge will be difficult to exit and take pictures, but please trust us that we will take the appropriate pictures and you will be able to see them from our photographers. I want to introduce a couple of distinguished guests on stage today, and they are Daedra Avery, the senior counselor, Dennis Chowan, president of the Meade 46-1 school board, and Mr. Simmons, the superintendent of the Meade school district, as they will assist us in the presentation of the diplomas later today. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the superintendent of Meade schools, Mr. Jeff Simmons.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Sturgis Brown High School in the 2020 commencement program. I am Superintendent Simmons, and I would like to extend a special welcome to family and friends, distinguished alumni, and most important, the graduating class of 2020. I would also like to take a moment to thank the faculty, administration, counselors, support staff, parents, and everyone that helped in the education of this class. I know that you are extremely proud of their accomplishments and are excited about the fact that they are ready for the next venture in life. At this time, it is my great pleasure that I introduce our first speaker, Jillian Sutton, the daughter of Eric and Karen Sutton. Jillian has one older sister, Aisling. Jillian is a national competitor for the speech and debate team, president of the Journalism Club, co-editor of the student newspaper, and active member in YLT and student council. Jillian enjoys climbing, hiking, and spending time with her friends. She will be attending Wesley College this fall for environmental sciences with an emphasis on policy and government. Jillian.
I'm so happy to be here this afternoon. Even if it's not in the way that all of us wanted, I'm still so happy to be able to spend this momentous occasion with all of you. So with that, welcome parents, family members, friends, and my senior classmates. Entering into my senior year, I was enthusiastic to say the least. We were finally the top of the food chain, a chain that we had been climbing for 4 years. I was excited for our last football games, pep assemblies, homecoming, but I was most excited to do it surrounded by a class I had grown up with since seventh grade. I had a picture in my head of the perfect senior year, the one seen in movies, the ones where the whole year flies by, but the most important moments go slow. It was a time I didn't realize I had been so excited for until it was taken away. On a random Friday in March, that picture got flipped upside down, stretched and contorted into something I never expected, something I never could have even imagined. My perfect senior year was now whittled down to Zoom classes, Google Classroom, and Schoology as my main form of contact with the people I have seen every day for the past 6 years. Yet, somehow our teachers made it seem like we weren't so alone. So I want to thank them. Slowly, spring semester, sports, prom, and even seeing my friends was taken away. COVID-19 has changed all of our lives in ways that we won't forget. All of a sudden, in a span of days, millions lost their jobs, their loved ones, their school days, and any sense of normalcy. I'm sure my whole class can attest to the amount of times people have told us, oh, but you'll never forget this year, or you'll have so many great stories. And while that's true, I'll have some pretty great stories of me sitting home alone doing calculus on my dining room table for 3 hours. I wanted my story to go just like I imagined it. We are a generation born from 9/11 and graduating amidst one of the most tumultuous health epidemics our country has faced. We have grown up through huge changes in our nation. The same events that used to happen over 50 years now taking place in 18. But despite all of this, our generation has proved that we are resilient. While we can't control the huge events that have plagued our childhoods, we can control our responses to them, and coronavirus is no exception. This pandemic has shown, if nothing more, the compassion of our class and our ability to keep fighting. We will have obstacles and struggles in the future. There is no doubt about that. But being the class of 2020, we have been given the incredible opportunity to show our resilience. Hindsight is 2020. Our class can look into the past with perfect vision to see how far we have come and how much we have accomplished amidst so much turmoil. The past has always been the best indicator for the future. So, with hindsight that shows us our strength, let's look towards the future with the same tenacity that has gotten us through these past few months. Because all of us are adaptive, innovative, and we hold an incredibly important role in changing the future of our world.
At this time, I'd like to introduce Ryan Conover, our class poet. Ryan is the oldest child in her family. Her parents are Amy Conover and Mike Rodas and PJ Conover. She has a younger sister, Riley. Ryan is a soccer player, a member of the speech and debate team, and the co-president of the art club. She is interested in conspiracy theories, art, and adventuring. Ryan spends her time painting, reading, hiking, and being with her friends. Ryan will be attending the University of South Dakota to major in English education and minor in history education. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ryan.
Dear class of 2020, never forget the joyful freedom of a bicycle, riding for hours until the sun lost its glow. Remember ice cream cones, sunny days, bee stings, and scraped knees. Never forget bedtime stories, because I was once told that life was only limited by our imagination. Remember space exploration, dinosaur bones, mystery solving, and magic. Never forget how the world sat, humbled in the palm of your hand, though you never stopped questioning the universe. Remember the twinkling stars, deep oceans, blooming flowers, and endless forests. Never forget when the world began to shift. Suddenly, all things became incomprehensible. Remember stress, anxiety, anger, and failure. Never forget the loss of things never to be regained. However tragic, through all of this, we have learned to persevere. Remember difficulty, disappointment, loneliness, and lost time. But never forget who stood by your side, the ones who put the pieces of the puzzle back together. Remember empowerment, joy, compassion, and love. From heartbreak to happiness, look at how far we have come. Be thankful for the things that you have experienced and the friends and family who have stayed by your side. They have helped shape you into who you are today. Remember that your life thus far has led you to this moment. And as we move forward to bigger and better things, never forget. Thank you.
Lydia Rotterdam, class speaker, daughter of Matthew Rotterdam, Rochelle Birch, and David Brooke, excuse me, Rochelle. Sister to Tanner, Evan, and Liam Rotterdam. Sister-in-law to Becca Rotterdam. Lydia is a player on the high school's varsity softball team and a national competitor on the speech and debate team. Lydia spends her time playing Dungeons and Dragons, painting, and hiking. Lydia will be attending Casper College, competing on their speech and debate team. She hopes to minor in communication and major in political science. Ladies and gentlemen, Lydia Rotterdam.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today is an exciting day. Today, the class of 2020 graduated. Now, graduates, I don't know if you know me or not, but we went to high school together. Anyways, I have spent all of my high school years here at Sturgis Brown. And if I'm known for anything in this high school, it is that I am ruthlessly, brutally honest. And to be honest with all of you, I have thought about how to start this speech over and over again. It is hard to describe feelings that are so complicated. Excitement, fear, nervousness, but overall happiness. I know what I should tell you. I should say something about how the next step in life is going to be amazing. I should say something about how all your hard work and dedication will land you that dream job and life will be good. I should give some motivational quote, explain the motivational quote, and say how it's better any advice, any than I could ever give. I know all the things I should do. But I can't help but to think why I should use another's words to sum up my life experiences. So I will try to sum them up for you as best as possible. My chapter at Sturgis Brown High School cannot be reread. I cannot re-experience it even if I wanted to. The pep rally chants are forever etched into the walls of my memory. The football games are a slow motion picture playing on repeat. And the lunchroom. I can't really say too much because the first rule about Fight Club is we don't talk about Fight Club. But what I can talk about is this year's graduating class. My friends, my foes, my people. We grew up together. We know each other whether we'd like to admit it or not. And I'd be the first one up here to say that I am sad to see all of us leave. Don't get me wrong, I'm ecstatic to watch the class of 2020 to take the world by storm. But these last 4 years I have experienced with all of you mean something to me. Whenever I see one of you accomplish your goals or a dream or overcome an obstacle, I will smile to myself and be proud. When I see Ricky Clark major in computer science and create something new for the technology world, I will be filled with joy. When Lane Matthews starts to climb the ranks of the Air Force, I will be honored to say that we were friends. When Olivia Overvold becomes a famous singer I always knew she could be, I will say, hey, I know her, we had choir together. Class of 2020, we finally did it. We made it through the unnerving freshman year, the awkward stages of sophomore year, completing the stressfulness of junior year, and finally making it through the home stretch of senior year. Now, this home stretch has took many twists and turns along the way. None of us expected us to end our senior year during a pandemic slash quarantine slash Tiger King movie marathon, but in the end, we all know Carol Baskin did it. I am proud of us for graduating during these times of uncertainty. Thank you to my fellow classmates who spent all these years with me. I send thanks to the teachers and staff for molding us and shaping us into the young adults we are today. Most of my thanks goes out to the family members that had to deal with us during our mood swings and teenage drama years. But the world is waiting for us. We cannot slow down now. We are the future. Let us show us what we have to offer. The world won't wait for us, so we better start catching up to speed. And just like the beginning of this speech, I can't figure out how to end it in any better way than saying class of 2020, we did it. And Sturgis Brown, hats off to thee.
Danica Gordon. Danica is a daughter of Bruce and Kendra Gordon and a sister to Bridger, Matea, and Bennett Gordon. A 10-year 4-H member, Danica has been involved in showing meat goats competitively on the state and national level and has also earned national honors in public speaking as well as range and livestock judging. At Sturgis Brown High School, Danica has been active in student council, FFA, journalism club, and youth leadership team. She has also authored 3 children's books, one of which has been read online by 98,000 people. Danica will attend South Dakota State University, majoring in agribusiness and human resource management. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me introduce Danica Gordon to the stage.
To my Sturgis Brown High School senior classmates, our parents and families, Superintendent Simmons, Principal Wilson, teachers, members of the Mead School Board, and all the amazing community members, family, and friends who are listening online. I am honored to have the opportunity to speak at our Class of 2020 graduation today. As we have prepared for this moment, I know that all of us have felt many emotions. Happy, excited, anxious, eager. Those were certainly some of the feelings I had when our senior year began last August. And if we all think back to when we started kindergarten in the fall of 2007, we were a class of happy faces, anxious to meet our new classmates, and eager to learn our ABCs. And who knew back then that one of the most important things we learned was how to wash your hands? More recently, the world changed and some of our excitement has been replaced with frustration, disappointment, and even some sad tears. But think back again on those past 13 years. This mix of emotions of happy and sad, excitement and disappointment has been a part of our school journey throughout elementary school, middle school, and high school, because it's real life. As a friend reminded me recently, life doesn't always go according to plan. For example, sometimes we study for a test and get that A, or our basketball team brings home that win. Other times, we don't always get the outcome we worked for. Those are lessons I believe we've all learned as we've worked towards this graduation day these past 13 years. As we take this day to celebrate our goodbyes to high school and look forward to the future, I want to take a minute to encourage my classmates to always remember your ABCs. A stands for adapt. This is something we've certainly learned to do these past 3 months with online schooling and multiple Zoom calls. But we've been adapting from the first day we started kindergarten. And today, some of us have mastered chemistry and Spanish, and some of us are really good at finding funny TikTok videos. Bottom line, when life throws us curveballs or hands us lemons, we need to be flexible, look for new solutions, and adapt. B stands for build. Build your knowledge and your skills. That's a focus of our time in school. But I hope we also realize how important it is to build involvement, build friendships, and build memories. Because time goes fast, and we are the builders of our past, present, and future. Finally, C stands for connect. Throughout the past 13 years, we've made some awesome friendships. And during the past 3 months, we've had a lot of time to connect with family. Maybe a little bit too much for some of us. But I hope we've all realized that connecting counts to share stories, ideas, tears, and laughter. Today is the last day that we, the Sturgis Brown High School class of 2020, are all in the same place, connected by our time in school together. Let's remember to reach out and connect with each other and our community in the future. To my classmates as we go forward, let's focus on being happy, excited, anxious, and eager for the new chapter ahead in our lives. And let's remember our ABCs, to adapt, build, and connect. And always remember to wash your hands.
Thank you, class speakers. I would like to recognize and thank some of the people who have made today's ceremony possible. Teachers and support staff, I thank all of you who have helped this class for the last 13 years. Thanks for all the hard work, dedication, encouragement, and support throughout the years. This day would not be possible without you. Parents and guardians, I would also like to say thank you for your support and guidance of your children throughout the years, and I hope today brings you joy and celebration as your child graduates. The Meade School District 46-1 Board of Education has determined the graduation requirements for Sturgis Brown High School is to complete 24 credits to include 4 units of English, 3 units of social studies, science, and math, 1 unit each of physical education and health, a fine arts, and a personal finance and career planning, 1 unit of a world language or a approved career and technical education class, and 7 units of electives. These individuals before us have completed all their graduation requirements and are ready to receive their diploma. Class of 2020, it is now time to get your diploma.
find parking places and drive up to the front of the stage where the graduate will get out of their car and cross the stage and get that most important piece of parchment.
And that old wind, had it not been for that old wind today, it would have been a beautiful day today, but it seems like that wind kind of got stronger here as we move to the afternoon hours. All right, Terry, I'll let you have the first graduate here for my friend.
Okay, sounds good. First graduate up is
Delaney Rose Allen. Highest honors.
Boy, that was stereo. Pete
that
Wilson
was good.
And I, stereo.
Pete Wilson in there, yep.
Delaney will be attending Minnesota State University, Mankato, to major in criminal justice and plans on a career in law enforcement. Congratulations, Delaney.
And Delaney Rose Allen will exit stage right.
Nathan Price
and
Anderson, highest honors.
Stage left, Nathan Price Anderson. Nathan will be attending the South Dakota School of Mines and Technology and major in biomedical engineering, thanking his family and friends for all their support
Bo
throughout the years.
Carter Austin.
All right, up next is Bo Carter Austin. Went to Bo's graduation party last night at the Knuckle. He's going to go up to Alberta, Canada to attend Olds College. He's going to major in meat science. He says he wants to thank God and his mama. Congratulations, Bo.
And that will bring our next graduate.
Jody Lynn Francis Barden.
Lynn Francis Barden. While in high school, Jody was actively involved in choir, debate, and placing often. She also was involved in oral interpretation during her 4 years of high school. Congratulations, Jody Lynn Francis Barden.
Okay, our next graduates. Jordan Lynn Bass. Jordan will be attending Black Hills State University. Jordan, obviously a bigger brain than I have. She'll be majoring
Lynn
in physics.
Bass.
So congratulations,
highest
Jordan
honors.
Lynn Bass, graduate of Sturgis Brown High School.
And she will accept, we are watching on the screen here, she will accept her diploma and exit stage.
Maximilian
right.
Battelli.
Next, that will bring up Maximilian Battelli. And Maximilian plans to go into project search. Congratulations to Maximilian Battelli. And I think we're waiting for him to come up stage left yet.
I think we
Emily
are.
Emily Kathleen
okay,
Bates.
Our next graduate
highest
is
honors.
Emily Kathleen Bates. Emily will be pursuing an undergraduate degree in chemistry at the place where we went to school, Black Hills State University.
Hill State University, yep.
Drake Michael Eugene
and that will bring up next,
Bogart.
Drake Michael Eugene Bogart. He is leaving in September. He has enlisted in the Marines, and he enjoyed welding and machinery during his high school years, and he loved those hands-on activities. Gotta love him for that.
Definitely. And he's going to be a Marine. Got to salute
yep.
him for that, too.
You bet.
Congratulations, Drake. Okay, our next graduate getting lined up here as they prepare on the stage.
August Christian
it's August
Bowman.
Christian Bowman. August plans on being a music teacher involved in band and exploratory music. You know, I've always found that folks interested in music always have a good brain for math, too.
Yep.
I didn't fall in that category, but August is going to fill those shoes as a music teacher.
Blaine
up
Thomas
next on the stage.
Breath.
Blaine
highest honors.
Thomas Breath. And he is going to be a member of the United States Air Force. We salute you. He was involved with track and cross country during his high school years, and
Siobhan
he missed out
Cheche
on his senior
Bromwich.
Track and field.
All right, up next is Siobhan Sashay Bromwich. Siobhan, going to head to college. She was involved in choir and drama here at Sturgis Brown High School.
And that'll bring our next graduate up here, stage left. And that will be Kiera Ray Brown. Kiera Ray Brown plans to attend the University of Wisconsin-Stout in the fall.
Kiera Ray
will be doing
Brown.
Gymnastics and plans to study pre-chiropractic. What a great profession. She thanks most importantly her mom and grandma for all their support. through the years. Congratulations, Kiera Ray Brown.
Okay, up next, we heard from her earlier on the senior moments. It's Avery Grace Bunch. Avery, going to head to Gillette Community College and wants to get a real estate license and sell properties. She thanked her teacher, Carrie Van Zee, said it was a big person in her life here at Sturgis Brown High School. The administration, she wants to thank them as well for not giving up on her
Avery,
on her non-traditional
Grace
student
Bunch.
Ways. I can say that you and I probably fell in that category as well. Not the traditional student way.
That's right.
But Avery Grace Bunch, congratulations.
All right, our next graduate who is coming up stage left will be Jalen Paul Burke. And Jalen has enlisted in the Navy.
Jalen Paul
Burke. Well, we've got all the services covered
Rachel,
so far.
Julia,
Air Force,
Burkhalter,
Navy, Marine.
Highest honor.
The Army. Missing the Army.
But that's coming, I think. I think we got some Army folks coming up here soon. All right, got our next graduate lined up and ready to go. Rachel Julia Burkhalter will cross the stage next to get that diploma. Rachel going to attend the University
Jalen
of Central
Paul
Florida.
Burke.
Yep, and Jalen Paul Burke is just now getting his on stage, and then, yep, you'll have the next one there. And we were just talking about the University of Central Florida and how it's become quite the prestigious college. It is really moving up in the ranks when you talk about major colleges. And UCF now is actually becoming a very popular place to go. They have some fabulous programs that are on the cutting edge there now, and she's going to be attending there.
Yeah, with the weather we've had recently, I could see why a student would want to attend University of Central Florida. Got a little ahead of myself there on the graduate.
Yep.
Sorry about that.
And she was Air Force ROTC, too.
Okay, I think Rachel Julia Burkhalter will be up here shortly.
She will be our next one who will be coming stage left here. And of course, Pete Wilson is announcing the names as well on stage as we are on the air. So you'll hear him in the background a little bit here.
You know what? I guess I need to slow down and give them a chance to get out of their vehicles.
Justin Thomas Burnham.
All right. Justin Thomas Burnham is our next one after Rachel wraps up with hers. And Justin is heading to the Air Force and college in the fall. So congratulations to Justin Thomas Burnham.
Outstanding player on the Scooper football team as well. He'll be missed next year.
And Kennedy
Kennedy Lynn Bush. Kennedy is going to attend Southeast Technical College. She'll major in Diagnostic Medical Sonography. So congratulations, Kennedy Bush.
And that just shows how smart Kennedy was, because she would outsmart me even when she was a kid, when she would come up to the house and visit the wife and I, yes. Congratulations, Kennedy. Our next graduate coming up, stage left, will be Annie Elise Calhoun.
Highest
and
honors.
She plans to attend Montana State University Billings to become a paramedic, and she would like to thank the school and her parents for all their support over the years. Congratulations to Annie Elise Calhoun.
Glory.
All right,
Ann
up next, the homecoming queen for Sturgis Brown High School, Glory Ann Christensen. Glory is going to major in medical biology at the University of South Dakota. She wants to thank her family for always being supportive. Also wants to thank her teachers for educating and pushing her to be better. Congratulations, Glory Christensen.
All right, that will bring our next graduate up, and that is Ricky Edward Clark III. And computer science is what he lists his major as.
I heard his graduation one of the speakers mentioned
Ricky
in her,
Clark
her
III,
remarks.
Highest honors.
An up-and-coming computer science major.
Yep.
And you can hear the wind just whipping through the tents here. The graduates holding on to their caps as they walk up across the stage, trying not to lose them. Some of them have
Brandon
their caps bedazzled, which
William
is something new this
Clausen.
Year.
Honors.
All right, up next, Brandon Lee William Clausen. Brandon is attending Black Hills State University. He wants to thank my wife, Pam Anderson, and also Pam Geese, in the front office for providing such a positive environment every day. Congratulations, Brandon Clausen.
How many front offices do you know that have a pair of Pams?
There's actually three.
Who work so
up
hard?
There.
Is there three? Yeah.
Pam,
how about that?
Pam Vinson. So
that's right. I forgot about her.
It's the Pams. It's plural.
Our next graduate coming up will be Taylor Lane Caulfield. Excuse me, Taylor Lane Caulfield, and Taylor plans to attend Western Dakota Technical College for diesel mechanics. They had institute on the paper, but it's now college.
Okay.
After the legislature changed that this year.
Taylor.
Yeah, you
Lane
would know that, wouldn't you?
I would know that. I covered a lot of lectures. Ah, there's the air horns.
Yeah, we knew we'd see some of those.
Congratulations, Taylor, and good luck at Western Dakota Technical Institute.
And you know they've
college.
College. They've relaxed a few of the requirements here this year. They're letting the students bedazzle their graduation caps because
Gage Michael Conley.
Let's make it special for these young men and women. Gage Michael Conley also graduating. Enjoyed artistic endeavors, and he's entering the workforce. Congratulations, Gage.
And that will bring up next
Ryan
Ashley
Conover. Highest honors.
Who plans to attend the University of South Dakota as a secondary education major. And he thanks his mom for always pushing him to work hard in everything he did and supporting him in every new step he took. Congratulations to Ryan Ashley Conover.
Ryan also the class poet, as we heard
he
from her heard from her recent just a few minutes ago. All right, our next graduate standing on stage left,
Colton James
Cruikshank. Colton Cruikshank will be attending Lake Area Tech in the fall. It's out in Mitchell. He's going to study precision machining in Lake Area Tech, another one of those up-and-coming schools that a lot of students love to go to get that hands-on work experience. And I don't know
Austin
what the hiring rate is out of that school, but it's really good. Austin Dirk also being recognized as a graduate this year at Sturgis Brown High School.
And he is next in alphabetical
Dean
order.
Donaldson.
And that'll bring next to the stage Clinton Dean Donaldson. He has signed a letter of intent to rodeo for Gillette College and study welding technology. And he thanks his family for always supporting him in everything he did. Congratulations to Clinton.
Brooke Madison Douglas.
Brooke, involved in rodeo here at Sturgis Brown High School. Brooke will attend nursing school. Doesn't say which nursing school, but guaranteed to get a job out of school. I see a lot of folks going into the healthcare fields, and of course right now a renewed emphasis on those types of career fields and the frontline workers. We need to salute them today too for all that they do for us.
And she was involved in rodeo as well, the Sturgis Rodeo Club.
Congratulations, Brooke Douglas.
All right, that'll bring up our next graduate, and that is Cy Thomas Eichenberger. And Cy is pursuing a physical science degree at Shadron. And of course, he's going to play football as well.
Cy
he said his
Thomas
name several times during the football season this year. Congratulations,
sure
Cy.
Yeah, he'll be another one that's missed on the football field for the Sturgis Scoopers. Cy Eichenberger, congratulations.
Headed down to Shadron State. He's going to be an Eagle. And I do believe Shadron State plays Black Hill State in football now.
Kaylee Ann Eichenberger.
All right, up
honors.
Next, Kaylee Ann Eichenberger. Kaylee will be going to Gillette College. She's going to pursue a degree in elementary education. Congratulations, Kaylee Eichenberger.
And our next graduate up will be Cody
Walker Emick. Honors.
And Cody is going to attend South Dakota State University in the fall, and he will be studying exercise
Trevor
science.
Lee Erlenbush.
Trevor
highest
Erlenbush.
Honors.
Middle name Lee. Up next across the stage, Trevor attending USD. He wants to thank his parents, his sister, teachers, and coaches for supporting him, pushing him to be his best. Another outstanding high school football player and just all around young man of character. We heard him on the senior moments a bit ago with Francie Ganji, and what an articulate young man.
Yep. All right, our next graduate who will be receiving his diploma on stage is Felicity Athea Ferwerda. And Felicity is planning on attending a culinary program at Johnson & Wales University. That is in Denver, Colorado, if you didn't know, my friend.
I did not know that.
And he wants to thank Colleen Keffler for all the hard work she put into her job and how excited she has made
Ferwerda
her for career in the food industry. We could see her on the Food Network in the future.
That's one of my favorite channels, especially during this time of social distancing and quarantining. I think I need to watch the Weight Loss Network here pretty soon so I can try to drop a few pounds. I've gained a few over this last month or so.
All right, that'll bring up our next graduate. Do you have the next one or do I? I lost track of that, however.
I think I do.
Okay.
All right, Jonathan Lee Fisher coming up next here across the stage. Jonathan going to attend university for exercise science and kinesiology. Going to study the movement of the human body and
Jonathan
how
Lee
to get in shape.
Fisher.
Not only
honors.
Is that word hard to say, it's fun to say.
It is. It is. Kinesiology and exercise science, another popular, one of those popular majors and one of those things you could really go on and get your master's and doctorate in if you chose to.
Absolutely.
Congratulations, Jonathan Fisher.
All right, our next student up is Chad Michael Forrester. Chad enjoys mountain biking and the great outdoors. He helped create
Chad
some of those biking
Michael
trails for his
Forrester.
Senior project.
I've ridden quite a few of those trails around the Sturgis area, too, some up near Fort Meade. An unbelievable job that they did with the trails program and how they all interconnect. Yeah, good job, Chad. His senior capstone project really made life a little better for a lot of residents around Sturgis.
Congratulations, Chad.
All right, up next, it's one of our favorite young men, All-State football player, Joshua Michael Fowler. Josh Fowler plans to head to the University of South Dakota, where Josh will
Joshua
pursue
Michael
a degree in business,
Fowler.
Finance, and analytics. He wants to thank his coaches, his teachers, and his family, Eric and Tracy, and Lauren, whose birthday it is today.
That's right.
And her brother, Jarrett, for their support. Congratulations, Josh Fowler. Hard to believe he's graduating. I remember him being a little tyke.
The years go by fast.
Oh, they sure do.
They sure do. All right, up next is Laura.
Laura
Elise Freeman.
Freeman.
And Laura plans to attend Western Dakota Tech in the fall. That's Western Dakota Technical College.
I don't think anyone's going to forget that now.
Well, the legislature made sure I didn't because I called it institute in front of a state senator and he corrected me.
Lauren
Ann
okay,
Fritz.
Up next, Lauren
Highest
Ann
honor.
Fritz. Lauren will attend the South Dakota School of Mines and Technology. Lauren plans on majoring in mining and geological engineering. She wants to thank her teachers, especially Mrs. Buckles, who pushed her to be her best. Mom Lori got to be very proud today. Lauren Ann Fritz graduating from Sturgis Brown High School.
Brianna Curran.
Up next,
Gary.
Brianna.
Highest honors.
Kieran Gary. And she is going to be post-secondary education for psychology. Well, that's a tough major.
It is, yeah, for sure. Studying the human mind.
Mm.
Eden Rose
Up next,
Gibson.
Eden Rose Gibson. Eden appreciates support from Mrs. Van Zee, student services, her teachers, and everyone for helping her persevere and succeed. Eden plans to attend Western Dakota Technical College for phlebotomy.
There's another good major. These kids are spreading their wings.
They are. And
love
just
it.
A good variety of majors.
All right, our next student up is Dylan Robert Gillespie. And Dylan plans to attend Dakota Wesleyan University and play baseball for the
Dylan
Tigers while
Robert
majoring in elementary
Gillespie.
Education with a minor in coaching. Congratulations, Dylan Gillespie.
You had to say that B word, didn't you?
I did.
Baseball. We are missing sports.
Looks like
as
we might get it
is.
Back pretty soon, though.
I hope so. Dylan Gillespie, outstanding baseball player for the Scoops and for the Titans. All right, up next, one of the class speakers we heard from just a little bit ago, Danica Grace Gordon. We'll come up stage left here in just a moment. Danica will attend South Dakota State University. Danica plans on majoring in agribusiness and human resource management. Danica wants to thank her family and friends for being positive role models in her life. Danica, I had to say too, Danica, Lydia, Ryan, and Jillian, the class speakers.
Yep.
Outstanding job trying to encapsulate what has become of their senior year and trying to make the most out of a tough situation.
Indeed. Our next graduate up is Mackenzie Lane Ryan
Danica
Grams.
Grace Gordon.
I think Danica's highest finally honor. Making it across
the stage. Danica's going to get up there, okay?
I got ahead of myself
again,
Jerry.
Yeah, you did. That's all right. That's all right.
There's our friend Bruce Gordon in his nice yellow Camaro.
So Mackenzie Lane Ryan Grams is next, and Mackenzie plans to attend Mitchell Tech to become an LPN, and thanks her friends and family for the constant support and always pushing her to do her best. Congratulations, Mackenzie Grams.
Yeah, and I love these people.
Lane, Ryan,
Grams. The vehicles driving by. Everybody's got a camera. That is probably the way to do it right there.
That's right.
That blue Jeep full of people. It's open air. They have a great position to get a picture of Mackenzie Grams grabbing her diploma. Congratulations, Mackenzie Grams.
And that will bring up our next graduate. Is this one mine or is this one yours?
I'll take this one.
Okay.
Kane Robert Grant. Just lining up here, stage left.
Robert Grant.
Kane plans to attend Oklahoma State horseshoeing. He's going to work on at a horseshoeing school in Ardmore, Oklahoma. He's going to school and partner in the family ranch. Would like to thank his parents for providing all the opportunities that they have for him. Kane Grant, we went to the Knuckle last night and we saw his setup
Emily,
for his senior party.
Emily Elizabeth Gray Smith.
Incredible. Congratulations, Kane.
Up next is Emily Elizabeth Gray Smith. Be joining the Army National Guard and then attending USD. Wants to give a special shout out to her grandparents for taking such good care of her the last 4 years.
They sure have. Another fine young woman of character, Emily Gray Smith. Congratulations.
We said her name in basketball and volleyball this year, I think.
And I can't believe it, Gary. I have the pleasure of announcing this next
That's
graduate.
Right.
We were wondering where this would fall, but his graduation cap just flew off. He's getting a little bit of help grabbing that. Justin Green, who was an outstanding football player. Justin Credible Green, our next graduate. Justin Credible, Gary.
He's just
Justin
incredible.
Credible Green.
He is.
He plans on going to the School of Mines.
Justin
He's gonna
Credible
study
Green.
Mechanical engineering. He's just an incredible person, really.
He is.
Justin Credible Green. Good football player, and he's got a brain on those brawny shoulders. He plans on going to the School of Mines. He's going to study mechanical engineering. Congratulations, Justin Green.
All right, our next graduate up is Eliza Genovi Gruba, who will be attending Dakota State University for elementary special education.
I know, Eliza, we saw her on the volleyball court quite a bit.
We did.
Seems like
Eliza
years ago.
It does, doesn't it?
Just Gruba. Last fall.
But highest honors.
Eliza, outstanding volleyball player for the Lady Scoops and had a lot of fun doing volleyball this season. And we'll miss her. We'll
we
miss
will.
Her. But congratulations, Eliza Gruba. Okay, we are up to our next graduate here. I want to get too far ahead of myself again as I have in the past.
They'll be coming up stage left.
Haley Lynn Hackett.
Okay, our
Hackett.
Next graduate, Haley Lynn Hackett. Haley plans to enter the workforce. She's very involved in fitness programs while in high school. And Haley Lynn Hackett getting her diploma here from Pete Wilson, Jeff Simmons, and Sturgis Brown High School graduate for 2020. Congratulations, Haley.
All right, checking our monitor here that we have. See our next graduate working their
Peyton
way to
Nicole
the stage.
Hansen.
And that will be Peyton Nicole Hansen. And she will be attending the South Dakota State University in Brookings in the fall. Going to be a jackrabbit.
All right. Tim Potts would be happy about that.
Are you telling me Tim Potts is a jackrabbit?
He is. Die hard. All right, our next graduate.
Anthony Ross Hayford.
Recognizing Anthony today, he'll be joining the military and hopefully the United States Army. not that I have a preference there, but go Army, beat Navy, I like to say from time to time. Pat West.
You say it every December when they play each other.
I do. Okay, right. It's a big rivalry.
It sure is. All right, Anthony Hayford will receive his diploma and bring up our next graduate. And this is going to be Holly
Honors
Rhiannon Height, who is going to attend Black Hill State University in the fall, and is highly motivated to helping save the planet. Holly's senior capstone focused on plants to helping out the bees as well.
Bryce,
help
Scott
the bee population.
Hill.
Well, congratulations, Holly.
You can't live without them. So.
That's right. All right, congratulations to Bryce Scott Hill. Bryce receiving his diploma. Prance plans on going into fire protection with the United States Air Force upon graduation. Congratulations, Bryce. Thank you for serving your country.
And Bryce Hill will exit stage right and bring up our next graduate, 53rd graduate for Sturgis Brown High School. In alphabetical order today is Julia Dream Hilpert. Julia will be attending the South Dakota School of Mines and Technology for chemistry and pre-med. And thanks all of those
Julia
who have worked to facilitate
Dream
this graduation
Hilpert
ceremony
honors
under difficult circumstances. And of course, the Senior Banners Project. Thanks to all who made that happen. They look so good downtown.
They sure do. It's fun to drive around town and just to look at all those. And it's a great way to just bring some more attention to these graduates and all they've accomplished. It's a great work by Powerhouse Dance DJs and sound production, and the also Bob Davis and Sturgis Photos with the shots we have on our
Nicole
monitor.
Beautiful. Hobbs.
Courtney Nicole Hobbs, our next graduate. Courtney plans on going to tech school after graduation. Congratulations. Courtney Nicole Hobbs, class of 2020, Sturgis Brown High School.
And Courtney Hobbs will receive her diploma here on stage. All right, that'll work up our next
Casper
graduate here. That
Hudson.
Is Casper Hudson, whose focus is digital arts, which is where she will be focusing her future plan. So congratulations, Casper Hudson.
Okay, our next graduate lined up stage left.
Sydney B. Hyman
plans on going post-secondary, wants to thank her parents and teachers for helping her get through all of this and all of this part of her life. She can't wait for the road ahead. She's attending the School of Mines to study chemistry. My daughter's a chemistry engineering major there, chemical engineering major, and I'd say she's picking
Destiny
one of the toughest
Lauren
majors you can pick
Igo
at School of Mines.
Honors.
Congratulations, Sydney.
All right, up next is Destiny Lauren Igo, who's going to attend South Dakota State University. And I figured that out because she had the jackrabbit flag already on the vehicle antenna.
Oh, wow.
She's going to major in nursing with a specialty in pediatrics. Thanks her mom and dad and grandparents and siblings, Dimitri and Dace. So Destiny will get her diploma. By the way, thanks Rapid City Summer Nights for the stage. And this stage is incredible here.
Sure is.
I thought it looked familiar.
been down there a few times, but yeah, it's an excellent setup here today, despite the circumstances here, the COVID-19
David
pandemic. This graduation's
Richard
pretty
Iverson
unique for sure.
Absolutely.
All right, up next, a young man, David Richard Iverson, crossing the stage. David plans on joining the Navy upon graduation. Thanks for serving your country, David.
Absolutely.
Richard Iverson. And come December, I'd have to say, beat Navy.
And he would have to say, beat Army.
That's right.
Yes.
I love my service member brothers and sisters, but there is a little rivalry in there, too.
Hayden
just a little bit.
Faye
just a little.
Jansen.
Our next graduate is Hayden Faye Jansen. Hayden is planning to be an Air Force firefighter. in the fall of 2021 is when he's anticipating heading there. So congratulations to Hayden. And now we'll have a couple of girls, I do believe, perhaps in the same vehicle. We might. Not yet. We've got a traffic jam here at the end, and we'll
Sarah
clear that out and bring
Ann
up our next graduate. There,
honors.
Mr. Terry.
All right, Sarah Ann Jans plans on joining the Air National Guard, then attend college. Sarah Jans, graduate, class of 2020. Her family driving by with big smiles on their faces right in front of us here. Sarah, an outstanding athlete on Scooper volleyball and basketball teams, and she'll be missed. And a student of honor, too, wearing the honor sash on her robe. Congratulations, Sarah Jans, 2020 graduate from Sturgis Brown. And thanks for serving your country, too, Sarah.
Absolutely.
Air National Guard.
Air National Guard.
Her mom said she's going into weapons.
Is that right?
Which Sarah thinks
Lynn
is pretty cool.
Job.
All right, our next graduate is Ashley Lynn Job. And Ashley is going to attend a post-secondary school by going to Gillette College to study business. I almost went that route, actually.
Did you?
I did. It was my kind of a secondary.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. We've had some good times.
I'd probably be sitting in a high-rise office instead of sitting here if I had gone that route.
You know, broadcasting
Aaliyah
doesn't pay well.
Kathleen Caskey, highest honors.
All right, coming up next. Next graduate is Aaliyah Kathleen Caskey. Aaliyah plans on working after graduation. Congratulations, Aaliyah. Aaliyah Caskey, graduating from Sturgis Brown High School.
And the students are getting their pictures taken when they do exit stage right. They'll get one taken with their mask on and then one without. And Tim Potts, I believe, is getting the professional
Trevor
ones at the end.
David Kyerlieber.
Our next one is
highest
Trevor
honors.
David
Kyerlieber.
Kyerlieber. I was going to see if you were going to say it first. He is going to attend the South Dakota School of Mines for Computer Engineering.
Yeah, we messed up Trevor's name a few times on the football.
We did.
But we have it right now. Kyerlieber. Trevor Kyerlieber, congratulations. We'll miss you on the football field, and we'll miss seeing your smiling face around the hallways at Sturgis Brown.
And knocking down the opponents.
That's right.
That too.
Yeah, he sure did. He put a hurting on some opponents this year.
Danae Kirk.
All right, up next, Kaylee Danae Kirk. Kaylee plans on attending Grand Canyon University in Phoenix.
Nice.
Kaylee is going to major in forensic psychology, daughter of a good friend of mine, a Newell Irrigator, Craig Kirk, and his wife, Jody. Kaylee Danae Kirk, congratulations.
Grand Canyon University.
Brett
fun.
That Walker
sound
fun. Konst.
That'll bring up next Brett Walker Konst. And Brett will be attending Gillette College and has been accepted into the diesel technology program. And he would like to thank all of the teachers who helped him reach his goals and his family for all their love and support.
And they're popping off
the
some
confetti poppers.
Confetti poppers.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
That was a good one.
It's a good thing there's wind. Good thing there's wind out there today. They're getting blown.
Congratulations, Brett Kahn.
It's kind of an east to west wind today, too.
Yeah, it is.
All right, up next is one of our favorite basketball players. He didn't get a ton of playing time,
Connor,
but when he did,
James Korth.
Man, he made the most of
he
it.
Did.
Connor James Korth. Connor plans on joining the Air Force. Like to thank all of his family and friends for their support during his high school career. I remember Connor Korth coming in and popping in some timely three-pointers for the Sturgis Scooper basketball team.
Oh, yes.
Congratulations, Connor Korth.
Marcus James
That'll
Kren.
Bring up Marcus James Kren. And Marcus Kren plans to enter the workforce, finishing
Ryder
off graduation here
Alan
for him.
Ladner.
Congratulations, Marcus.
You want to roll right into the next one, too?
Sure, you betcha. It'll be Ryder Alan Ladner. Ryder plans to attend the South Dakota School of Mines and Technology for Metallurgy and Mechanical Engineering.
Another outstanding Scooper ball player.
Absolutely.
And one of my neighbors up next
Lauren
here.
That's
Gabriel.
Right.
Legner.
Lauren
Honors.
Legner.
Used to be my neighbor.
Gabe Legner.
Before he moved to your neighbor.
That's right. Yep. Gabe's going to attend USD for medical biology and planning and plans on applying to med school. I'd like to thank all of his teachers, coaches, and his family who've dedicated their time and energy
Alex
to help him succeed.
Jordan
Congratulations,
Marr.
Gabe. Also recognizing graduate Alex Jordan Marr. Congratulations, Alex.
And that will bring up our next graduate after Alex Marr. Kyler
Hillis Maslin.
Maslin, who plans to work and attend technical school. Kyler Maslin, congratulations, Kyler.
And up next, one of my workout buddies.
Ah, used now this I did not know.
Yeah, I used to see him in the mornings at CrossFit. Lane Matthew, going to head to the Air Force. He would work out, and he would tell me he wanted to go into Air Force Special Operations. And, yeah, this young man is strong. I think he's going to do well in the military. He wants to thank his family, friends, teachers, directors, and coaches for all of their hard work in supporting him. Lane Matthew, congratulations. Sturgis Brown High School graduate.
Bodie John
Up next
Mattson.
Will be Bodie John Mattson. And Bodie plans to attend Gillette College and major in business. Congratulations, Bodie Mattson. Gillette College getting a lot of good Sturgis recruits here, aren't they?
I think Bodie involved
Jillian
pretty heavily
Lee
in rodeo, if I'm not mistaken. All right, Jillian Lee Mayer. Our next graduate, Jillian, is going to attend Black Hills State University in Spearfish. Congratulations, Jillian, and best of luck in your future endeavors.
Marin.
All right, our next
McGrath.
Graduate is
Marin
Lynn McGrath. Marin plans to attend the University of South Dakota and would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for all their support. Congratulations to Marin. Lynn McGrath.
Saw her in church this morning as they recognized the graduates at Mass.
Lexi Joe
Okay,
McKee
up next.
Hemingway.
Next graduate, Lexi.
Highest honors.
Joe McKee Hemingway. Lexi plans on attending USD to major in sociology, minor in political science. She wants to thank all the teachers that told her what she should do and what she should want to do and not listen to anyone else.
Jasmine.
That's what
Nicole
I'm talking about.
Milhouse.
Congratulations, Lexi.
Honors.
Our next graduate is Jaslyn Nicole Milhouse, and she will be attending Western Dakota Tech for criminal justice law enforcement emphasis and emergency medical sciences. She thanks her family for all the help they have done to help and to coach her along. Congratulations to Jaslyn Milhouse.
All right, up next, another one of those scooper Titan baseball players we saw on the field quite a bit. Gage Dalton Murphy headed up to the stage. Gage is going to join the South Dakota National Guard. He's going to become a heavy equipment operator, which is 12 November. That's what his MOS is going to be. He wants to thank his mom for always keeping him in line. Good job, Mom. Congratulations,
Murray.
Gage Murphy. Want to also recognize Christopher John Murray.
Mason
Chris graduating,
Lane
plans
Nash.
On joining the workforce.
Honors.
That'll bring up our next graduate. I'll wait for those to quit going off. Mason Lane Nash. And he's working towards an associate degree in computer-aided drafting and thanks his mom and dad for all their support. Congratulations, Mason Nash.
Yeah, some good air horns on that last
one.
They
were some very good air horns.
They tell you not to bring them in West Gym. Here they're like, hey, bring them.
Hey, we're outside today. That's right.
They bring them.
Cody John
up next.
Nelson.
Cody John Nelson, another outstanding gridiron football player. Cody plans on attending Dakota State University up in Madison. He's going to pursue a degree in exercise science and kinesiology. Going to play football. Wants to thank his parents and all the teachers who helped him along the way. Congratulations, Cody Nelson.
And I'll miss watching him play football next fall.
Yeah, he,
Gabriel,
another one of those young men
Nelson.
Who put a hurting on the opposing players.
Did. All right, our next graduate is Gabriel Runskill Nelson. Gabriel plans to attend college in the fall. Not sure where yet. But congratulations to Gabriel Nelson.
All right, Jace also being recognized,
Michael
Jace
Nelson.
Michael Nelson. Loves mechanics. Going to join the workforce after graduation. Congratulations, Jace.
All right, our next graduate who will come, coming up to stage left here,
Mason
and will walk the steps
Cole
right in front of
Newmiller.
Terry and I, as a matter of fact. We have a little cubby hole just enough to see the graduates. Mason Cole Newmiller, who plans to major in mechanical engineering at the School of Mines and then join the South Dakota National Guard as a helicopter mechanic. He thanks his parents, grandparents, coaches, and friends that made his high school career the best it could be. Congratulations, Mason
Kyle
Newmiller.
Wayne Nudd.
All right, up next,
honors.
Crossing the stage, Kyle Wayne Nudd. Kyle is going to work after graduation. Plans on making the world a better place. Congratulations, Kyle Nudd, 2020 Sturgis Brown
Sabrina
High School graduate.
Rose Oliver.
Also being recognized, Sabrina Rose Oliver. Plans on joining the workforce after graduation.
Olivia Brooke.
Up next will
Hogarth
be Olivia
Overvold.
Brooke Hogarth Overvold.
Highest
honor. Who
will
be attending Black Hills State University in Spearfish.
Another one of my workout buddies from CrossFit. Olivia, yeah, she could really hoist some weights. Why, she put me to shame on many a day. Congratulations, Olivia. All right, up next, one of my favorite graduates in this 2020 class.
Jacob.
Saw him in
Donald
Mass this morning.
Palmer.
Jacob Donald Palmer. Jacob plans on working. He said he's going to work at the, I think at Monument Health doing maintenance is what he told me this morning. Plans on doing that and wants to thank all of his teachers and mentors and wants to thank his family. Been big supporters of him over the years. And Jacob Palmer, class of 2020. Good to see him cross that stage.
Congratulations. All right, that will bring up our next graduate, Melsonina Kono Joe Parks.
Melsonina
Kono
Joe Parks.
Well, she says this is interesting. Auto 2 was her favorite class because it helped her develop into what she wants to be.
Awesome.
And also helped her with her future profession. So. Congratulations to Melsonina.
And I tell you what,
and that
Gary,
is Hawaiian. You know
it
that,
is,
don't
Brianna
you?
It is.
Marie.
Yeah, it is. Aloha
Paul
to Melsonina.
Highest honor.
Another one of my workout buddies, Brianna Marie Paul, also known as Breezy, Breezy Paul. She plans on joining the National Guard as a public affairs mass communications specialist. She's going to be a broadcast journalist in the
excellent
military. Going to go to basic training in October, and she's going to go to the University of South Dakota to major in criminal justice. Congratulations, Breezy Paul.
You might be able to give her some tips. You did broadcasting in the military.
I sure did.
Did?
If she asks.
Leota,
if she asks.
Agnes Pauling.
That was a long time ago, though.
I don't have a
honor
lot to pass on. But
next graduate is Antigone Leota Agnes Pauling. And Antigone anticipates attending Western Dakota Tech and to major in accounting.
Antigone.
So congratulations, Antigone.
Congratulations.
Tamara.
Okay,
and
up next,
Pete.
Tamara and Pete. Tamara going to Southeast Technical Institute. That's in Sioux Falls, or is it Southeast Technical College?
It's Southeast
now?
Technical College
okay
now. All the technical institutes are changed to college.
You told me that earlier.
Yep.
But,
Hugh,
yeah.
Eric,
congratulations,
Peldo.
Tamara.
That'll bring up Hugh Eric Peldo. And his future plans are simply to work.
Congratulations, Hugh. Things flowing along nicely here.
Very nicely
Emily
here today. We anticipated it would.
Pie.
Okay, Emily
highest
Ann
honors
Pye. Emily will go to South Dakota State. She's going to take up nursing there. Wants to thank her family and friends for all the support these past 4 years. Emily Pye, congratulations.
And that will bring up our next graduate, and that is Katie Jean Price. And Katie's plans are simply to work for now.
That's a good plan. They ask the young men and
plan
women to put down what they want to be in the future, but does anyone really know?
No, probably not.
Yeah, I always tell them write it in pencil because things will change.
Because sometimes you need to erase it.
You do. Things will change
Katie
a little bit.
Katie Jean Price.
Congratulations, Katie Jean Price. Oh, she's got a big
cannon, confetti cannon.
Big cheering section there, too, for Katie Price. Congratulations.
And as we watch our monitor here, Katie will get her photo taken and bring up our next graduate, Terry.
Okay, coming up next. Stage left here. Looks like there's a little gap
little
between
gap
the
there.
Cars.
Yep. So they'll get there. They'll catch up.
Working their way up to the stage. You know, you choreograph these vehicles, but it's definitely one of the more challenging graduation ceremonies we've seen. One of the more historic graduation ceremonies in that respect, where
Norma
never
Jean
seen one like
Probst.
This before. But coming up next, big cheering section for Norma Jean Probst. Norma going to attend USD in the fall. She's going to pursue a career in federal law enforcement. So
nice.
Congratulations, Norma Probst.
Then you're talking FBI or?
FBI. Bureau
Rachel
of
Rodunzi.
DEA.
Yeah,
that
there
sort
you go. DEA, that's federal. Yeah.
Federal, yep.
Yep.
Congratulations, Norma Probst.
All right, up next is Rachel Rodunzi. Interesting on her future plans there, living in a group home and securing employment.
Congratulations, Rachel.
That is Rachel Rodunzi. Thank goodness they got the pronunciation on there for that.
I thank
congratulations,
them for providing
Rachel.
Us with the phonetic spelling for some names, yeah. Okay, up next, coming up stage left here, it's Gabriel David Rambo. Gabe Rambo, outstanding soccer player
Gabriel
for
David
the Sturgis
Rambo.
Scoopers. He's going to attend South Dakota School of Mines and Technology. He's going to major in biomed. Going to play some college soccer, which, you know, that School of Mines program is just a few years old, but they're up and coming.
Mm-hmm.
Congratulations, Gabe Rambo, headed to the School of Mines.
All right, our next graduate coming up.
Marguerite Emily Reeve.
Marguerite Emily Reeve. And Marguerite will be attending college in Nebraska to pursue a career as a registered nurse.
Congratulations, Marguerite. And up next, a future South Dakota State Jackrabbit, Dalen Monroe
Dalen
Rhodes.
Monroe
Dalen Rhodes.
Rhodes.
Going to attend the South Dakota State University, study electrical engineering, become a jackrabbit. Congratulations to Dalen. A lot of Sturgis Scooper former students in Brookings,
yes.
So he'll
yes.
have a built-in family waiting for him there.
Yep.
Outstanding young man, too.
All right, after Dalen Rhodes, our next graduate is Austin Riley Robertson, and
Austin
he plans to work.
Riley Robertson.
Congratulations, Austin Robertson.
And one of our class speakers up next, I'd say her speech was very memorable.
Very.
We laughed.
We cried.
We cried.
We did.
Lydia, it was better than
Leona,
cats.
Leona Betty
Lydia,
Rotterdam.
Leona Yvette Rotterdam. Lydia Rotterdam plans on going to Casper College, compete on their speech and debate team. I can see her doing extremely well there.
Me
with
too.
The way that she delivered her speech today. She plans to minor in communications, major in political science. So Lydia Rotterdam, congratulations on your graduation today.
Ainsley Aaron
All right, up next
Sabers.
Will be Ainsley Aaron Sabers.
Ainsley.
Who plans to attend Xavier University in Cincinnati. And she's going to pursue a degree in biomedical sciences. Thanks her teachers, coaches, and administrators in the Meade School District and all the family for they have done. Of course, Ainsley is not quite a neighbor. She's in my
Bethany
neighborhood, though.
E. Schaefer.
Up on the top level, I'm on the bottom level.
All right, up next, Bethany E. Schaefer. Bethany plans on attending nursing school after graduation. Congratulations, Bethany, and thank you for going into a career field that has much, much needed.
On the front lines right now, isn't it?
Alexander K. Schmitz.
Also being recognized, Alexandra K. Schmitz. Alexandra, a 2020 graduate of Sturgis Brown High School. Congratulations.
And that will bring up next in line,
Cade Matthew Shrimp.
And Cade plans to, oh, here you go, Terry. United States Army.
Hooah. It's good to see Cade. I'd like to find out what job he's going into. It doesn't matter because it's still the best service.
Oh, dear.
All right, up next, our next graduate, Hannah K. Sko. Hannah's going to attend the University of South Dakota, major in pre-med. Great school for pre-med. Hannah, congratulations, a 2020 graduate of Sturgis Brown High School.
Hannah,
all right,
K.
that's gonna
Scow.
Okay, we're a little behind here. Pete Wilson just announced Hannah Scow. So Hannah will receive her diploma here. All right, that will bring up our next graduate, Braden Michael Seifert Bullet.
Michael.
He plans
Seifert
to attend the South
Bullet.
Dakota School of Mines and Technology
Highest
and major
honor.
In electrical engineering. Congratulations, Braden.
See quite a few students headed to the School of Mines as well
yes.
this year. Very affordable school, not far from home. And
the job placement rate at the School of Mines is unbelievable. It's in the 90 percentile.
It's outstanding.
Yep.
Catherine Rose
okay, up next.
Selting.
Next graduate is Catherine Rose Selting. Catherine, heavily involved in choir while she attended Sturgis Brown High School, plans on joining the workforce after graduation. Congratulations, Catherine. I know you'll do great things in the future.
All right, that'll bring our next graduate up, and that will be Kylie Marie Shaw. And Kylie plans to attend South Dakota State University in the fall and pursue a career in veterinary science. Congratulations, Kylie Shaw. You'll do well in veterinary science.
You know, and I think she's probably heavily influenced by her dad,
yep.
Les. Big cattle ranch out there by Red Owl,
yep.
White Owl.
They were busy over this past weekend. I've seen pictures on Facebook that Les was sharing. Branding season.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah,
for sure. Yeah, it's been a busy time for yeah.
I seen the Longs were branding,
there.
Too.
I think they help each other out
I
quite a bit,
do,
too,
yeah.
which is a good
Kylie
thing.
Kylie
yes.
Marie Shaw, highest honors.
So Kylie Marie Shaw just now called to the stage here, and you're going to get the next Shaw.
Sounds good. The cousin to Kylie Marie. We'll let Kylie get her official picture taken on stage right. But up next, outstanding scooper athlete. We saw play volleyball, basketball. Sydney J. Shaw. Sydney plans on attending USD. She's going to pursue radiology
Sydney
and run track.
J. Shaw,
such
highest
a positive,
honors.
Positive thinking young lady. Wants to thank her grandparents for letting her stay with them throughout high school. And parents for always pushing her to do her best. Sydney, going to be fun to see her run track at USD. Been a lot of scoopers that have run track on the Coyote track and field team.
And that will bring up our next graduate here as the Shaw girls wrap up pictures on the right side of the stage. Now, this is our right side. If you're out there in the parking lot, it's your left side. From Terry and I's vantage point, it's stage right. Up next, Zachary Aaron Sean. And Zach plans to attend South Dakota State University for Wildlife Sciences to become a game warden. We know he'll do well. I know Zach's grandpa and grandma were very, very happy with him this year. And
definitely fun to watch as the quarterback for the football team.
Yep. Played basketball.
One of those guys that head coach Darius Buss on the basketball team would say you can count on Zach for
Zachary
10
Aaron
points,
oh, yeah.
8 rebounds, and diving for loose balls. So good to see Zach Sean cross that stage and get that diploma. Congratulations.
classic Mustang for Zach today. I believe that's his papa's classic Mustang.
Wow.
I think that's Derek's, yep.
Beautiful car.
Clayton James
All right, up next,
Smith.
Clayton James Smith. Clayton plans on joining the South Dakota National Guard to become a mechanic. And as we know, the South Dakota National Guard is Army National Guard.
That's right.
Congratulations, Clayton Smith. And thank you for raising that right hand to serve your nation.
You bet.
Chloe Lane Stalder.
All right, our next one coming up, we had Clayton James Smith, followed by Chloe Lane Stalder. And Chloe plans to take a year off or two to try and start a business in makeup and fashion. And then if she says law school is a backup plan for her.
Jillian Raylin.
Congratulations
Sutton,
to Chloe.
Highest honors.
All right, up next is Jillian Raylin Sutton. We heard Jillian as one of the class speakers.
Yep.
Another articulate young lady. Plans on going to Wellesley College for her post-secondary studies. Congratulations, Jillian. Another one of those well-spoken young ladies you know is going to go on and do great things.
All right, after Jillian Sutton, up next is Haley Swanson. And her future plans right at the moment are unknown right now. She wrote on here, her mom wants her to get a job. I think everybody's mom wants her gets to get that job.
Haley
I think.
Swanson.
Most definitely, yeah. you just want your kids, you want them to succeed, whatever they want to do.
That's right.
You know, we tried not to plant a seed too much in any of our kids' brains, and they've all gone on to do great things, and they're still doing great things.
Congratulations, Haley.
Also being recognized, James Clay Tedder.
James Clay
joining
Tedder.
The workforce after graduation. Congratulations, James, as a graduate. Sturgis Brown High School.
Yep.
Parker
and somebody else
Thompson.
Who will be joining the workforce at the end of graduation. Up next is Parker Thompson. Congratulations, Parker. As Parker receives his diploma on stage here.
I know that's one of my wife's favorite students here, Parker. Always a smile on his face.
Yep.
Always comes into the office to say hi to my wife.
That's
and
awesome.
To the PAMs in the middle office or the front office. So congratulations, Parker.
And for the three PAMs, that's probably what they missed the most when school ended. The kids coming in and...
They come back and visit, and there's always tears. I mean, they just love these kids at this school. And they try to take care of them the best they can during the school. That's what they've missed a lot, I think, during this time when we've had to stay home is just the contact with the kids.
Yeah. Our next graduate is about ready to go here. We have getting pictures taken here on stage right. All right, that'll bring up next Tegan Christopher Thompson, who plans to attend the School of Mines and Technology to study mechanical engineering. Thanks his mom and dad for all of their support.
Another one of those graduates
Tegan
I saw in church this morning.
Thompson.
Didn't know much about him.
Highest honor.
We gave away a scholarship in our church to some of our young men and women that go to church. And got a chance to look at Tegan's transcript. Number one in his class. He's going to attend School of Mines. Extremely smart young man and just quiet and humble. I didn't know that about him until I saw his transcript. So congratulations, Tegan. I know he'll go on to do great things.
You betcha.
William.
Okay, our next graduate.
Tracy.
William Harry Tracy. William is going to attend Western Dakota Technical College. Doesn't say what he'll study, but... quite the array of subjects
to
study there.
It opens up a lot of roads for him.
Sure does. Congratulations, William Tracy.
Trayton.
That'll bring our next graduate up, and that is Trayton Randolph Turnbow. And he plans to continue to work and get his real estate license. Would like to thank his parents and friends. And of course, he can't forget about Mr. Miller. Big part of his life. Somebody lost their graduation cap here, and they got it back.
I think you might be referring to Kyle Miller,
Brooks,
who
Edward
outstanding teacher
Van
here at Sturgis Brown. All right, up next, Brooks Edward Van Pelt. Brooks plans on working after graduation. Congratulations, Brooks. Step one complete. Check off that graduation diploma on your plans, and best of luck
off
in your future.
Off to the next phase, yep. All right, our next graduate will be Jordan and Vaughn. And Jordan plans to attend school.
And
going to specialize in getting her nail technician license.
Congratulations, Jordan.
And they're catching up with cars here.
Getting down to about our last six or seven graduates here, so we're getting towards the end. It's really flown by. It's almost 3:25 right now, so, boy, it's flown by. All right, our next graduate.
Who I believe is on the way.
On the way. They're doing a good job managing
Marie
the traffic here.
Werlinger.
Tenley Marie Werlinger. Tenley plans on going to college for psychology. Congratulations, Tenley, and best of luck in your future. And I think maybe after this year, they're going to design some graduation caps with better elastic. We've seen quite a few of those fly off today.
It is windy today.
Grant
Our
Edward
next graduate,
Honors.
Grant Edward Willen. And he's unsure about what his future plans are.
Be honest, you know.
That's right.
Explore all your opportunities.
Check mark off school right now. And just not sure what lies ahead. So congratulations, Grant Willen.
Okay, our next graduates, Alexis Kate Williamson. Alexis plans on going to Western Dakota Technical College. Wants to thank
Williamson.
All of her teachers and the admin who made it able for her to graduate. She graduated a year early, Gary. Graduated from high school a year early.
That is awesome.
Good for her. And those kind of young men and women that have that drive. I mean, I would have stayed in high school a couple more years if it would have been possible, but my parents are like, you've got to finish up, son.
Leanne Williamson.
All right, our
highest
next graduate,
honors.
Lisa Leanne Williamson. And her future plans are to work, and gives a huge shout out to all her teachers and the administration for all their efforts under these difficult circumstances. Congratulations, Lisa.
All right, down to our last couple of graduates here. Okay, just walking up here stage. Left is Morgan Jana Wood. Morgan, involved in arts at Sturgis Brown High School.
Jana.
Enjoying the working world upon graduation.
Morgan Jana Wood.
Congratulations, getting your diploma as a graduate of the class of 2020. A historic graduating class here.
You did it sure
think,
is.
Think back to the class of 48, 49 when they had the polio epidemic.
They caught up with a graduate from 48 from Sturgis on one of the news stations in Rapid City, and it was very interesting, very interesting. All right, our final graduate, Caden William Zook, and his future plans are to enter the workforce. Congratulations, Caden William Zook.
Wow.
129 graduating seniors for the class of 2020 for Sturgis Brown High School.
Yeah, it's tough time. I mean, there's a lot of consternation, I guess you could say, when they were coming up with plans for this graduation, because there were so many unknowns when it comes to health, when it comes to safety. There was a lot of different places thrown around. The administration came up with this plan here in the parking lot of the high school. And I'll tell you, I think it is turned out better than anticipated.
I think so.
Just the amount of people involved to make this happen is incredible. And I think the graduates understand that it's about them getting their diplomas, but it's also about their family and friends who supported them on this journey. And the family and friends want to honor the graduate. You see the look in the parents' eyes when they're, you could see it right here. I mean, I could see Brenda Sabers and Scott Sabers when Ainsley got her diploma, and Brenda having a little trouble holding it together, you know, and it's about the support that the families have given them. And just for everyone to come together to make this happen, there's a lot of people to thank.
Oh, boy.
When we talk about it, you see the young men and women wearing the masks as they cross the stage to get their diplomas. Got to thank Fabric Junction, Chris and Terry Koontz, for the printed fabric for the masks. There's about 10 people that helped sew the masks. Terry Koontz, Marilyn Bates, Patty Van Heel, Colleen Kessler.
As the last graduates
DeCry,
make it back to their spots.
Ellie Anderson, Pam Geese, Sharon Vincent.
I want to remind you at the
Pam
conclusion
Anderson,
of graduation,
Carla
we will start
Linda
the
Bilkey.
Parade.
Congratulations and
the
thank you.
The ushers will direct you to the proper location
to sew
to
these
begin
masks
the parade.
For the graduates.
If you plan
and it's
on
a nice
being
little
part
memento,
parade,
I guess, from this ceremony.
Please follow the directions
all right, we'll take
to
it
the
to
west
Wilson here.
Entrance of the parking lot. That's where we will begin. If you are not going to partake in the parade, we ask you to exit the parking lot towards the east entrance. We are still waiting just a little bit before the last graduates get back, and then we will announce one last thing.
So the parade, by the way, in case you're wondering, it's going to be I know they'll be going up Junction. They're going to go around the elementary school up on Ballpark Road, and they will go around the hospital, so around the senior center there by the at hospital at Monument Health. They're going to go around, so they'll go up Harriman and then up Fulton, and then they'll get back on Junction. So,
yeah, it also goes kind of up through Murray Addition.
And up through Murray Addition, yep.
Up through the new Dolan Creek Estates. It goes up through that area too. So,
and they asked if you are on the parade route to social distance.
Yep.
So please do that.
Make a
it's
lot
kind
of
like
noise,
how the teacher,
too.
It's like the teacher parade. Yep.
At this time, it is my pleasure to present to you the Sturgis Brown High School Class of 2020.
A lot of balloons being let go and confetti poppers being set off. And kind of says it all. You can hear the horns. Rather than applause, you can hear air horns and car horns.
Yep. And Bob Davis has got fabulous photos from his drone. And we can see it on our screen here. And you can see that on the live stream if you've been tapping into the live stream here today. We can't thank Bob Davis enough. His drone footage is just unbelievable.
You may start leaving toward the same way that we just had the graduation, and they'll tell you the right direction to go. Thank you.
Pete Wilson, principal, Sturgis Brown High School. Outstanding job putting this together for the graduates and their families. Mead 46-1 Administration, Buildings and Grounds Crew, City of Sturgis, Sturgis Police Department. Got to thank Powerhouse Dance, DJs, Sound Production, Jacob West,
yeah,
part of that too. Rocking Tree Floral, AJ, A&J Screen Printing, Bob Davis for drone coverage, Rapid City Summer Nights for the stage, Black Hills Roundup, Terry Fralick Photography, Tim Potts Photography, and Superior Sanitation also. Yeah, graduate banners that you've seen around town provided by the Greater Sturgis Foundation, Sturgis Optimist Club, Downtown Sturgis Foundation, and the Home Slice Group. Rosemary Roth, a big part of that. She wanted to stay humble and stay in the background, but we're not going to let her.
We're not going to let her.
Because she does such a great job for this community, loves these kids, and wanted to recognize them with those banners. Numerous other people helped in some way. Teachers out here helping with traffic control, painting the lines and painting the numbers on the spots. A lot of community members. I mean, this whole community came together to make this happen for these young men and women, and can't say enough about
you
that.
You can't, no.
Yeah, I mean, it's historic in a lot of ways. Your first graduation that you've done on the air,
that's
mine
we've done
too.
On the air, yep. And it worked out well. We can't thank everybody enough who's helped make this possible. I got to get our sponsors in here, of course. And, of course, Sturgis Photo and Gifts really bent over backwards to really make this happen, both on KBHB. And Bob Davis has done such a wonderful job, and we can't thank him enough. Without his contributions and without his help, this couldn't have been possible to even foresee getting this on the air like we did today. So thanks to Bob Davis and everybody at Sturgis Photo and Gifts. And along with Sturgis Motorsports, Sturgis Chiropractic, and Ace Hardware in Sturgis, thank you guys so much. And of course, all our Scooper Sports sponsors, we got to get them in Flex Fitness and Sturgis CrossFit, Lynn's Dakota Mart in Sturgis, Rocking Tree Floral and Garden Center, Arby's of Sturgis, Northern Hills Eye Care, Castile Auction and Real Estate, and Lynn's Dakota Mart and Sturgis Quick Mart, and Sturgis Subs, which will be reopening this coming week as well. So thanks to all our sponsors for helping make the broadcast possible here today, my friend.
You know what? I also have to mention they've been doing this flower. They give away flowers here at the end of the ceremony, and this has been a few years in the making. They've done this for, now give it to a graduate, and the graduate gives it to someone who's meaningful in their life. So you see the graduates getting their flowers, handing them to their mom, their dad, their grandma, their grandpa. So I think that's a great gesture for the graduates to show who's important to them and who helped them on their journey.
Absolutely. All right. Again, we could, without all the folks who helped make this possible here today, considering all the tears and the emotions that we have seen since this pandemic, I think we knocked it out of the ballpark here today. Everybody comes together here, and I think this is going to be a graduation. This class of 2020 won't forget anytime soon.
Nobody will forget it, and it still remains to be seen, I guess, what's going to happen this summer, this next fall. Don't want to look too far ahead. You don't want to, like my wife says, you don't want to buy trouble. You just want to kind of live in the moment, and that's what today was, just living in the moment. And honor these young men and women and their accomplishments and send them off into the next phase of their life. Because you think about, you know, going back a ways, your graduation, high school graduation, and mine, it's a long time ago.
Yeah.
But it's memorable, especially the graduation. But it's just one small portion of your life. But you have to recognize what they've done and honor them and show them that that you love them and send them on their way. And with that little piece of paper that says high school graduate.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We will not forget you, and congratulations and good luck in all your future endeavors. All right, we're going to wrap things up here from our live broadcast, and we'll get back to our normal Sunday programming at 4 o'clock. Kevin Phillips Classic Country and the Red Steagle Cowboy Corner will be coming your way. So we'll have Red Steagle coming your way at 4, and then Kevin Phillips will come your way at 5 tonight. So for Terry Anderson, Gary Matthews, we bid you adieu from Sturgis Brown High School, and congratulations to the 2020 graduates.
Aloha.